Let's learn how to implement Font Awesome into our Bootstrap project. Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. In this tutorial, we are going to understand how to install Font Awesome into our current Bootstrap project. In doing so, the first thing that we have to do is to download the Font Awesome icons of the website. So that is why we will be going to Google, and here we will be typing Font Awesome, and here we can see that this is the official site of Font Awesome. Now in this context, I would like to say that Font Awesome is a free and open source. Font Awesome is fully open source and is GPL friendly. You can use it for commercial projects, open source projects, or really just about whatever you want. In its home page, the first thing that we are going to do, we are going to download this Font Awesome font and CSS toolkit. So we'll be pressing download, and then there will be a zip file which will be containing the Font Awesome CSS and fonts toolkit. On extracting it, we will be getting Font Awesome CSS and fonts. So these two things are required in this case. If we get back here, we can see that inside this CSS, so far there's no installation of Font Awesome. So the first thing that we are going to do, we are practically getting back to Font Awesome, and inside this CSS folder, we are going to copy these two files, and we are going to place it inside our CSS folder. So here it is. I have pasted these two CSS files over here, fontawesome.css and fontawesome.min.css. Now the next thing is, get back to Font Awesome folder that you have downloaded off the internet, and inside this fonts folder, you will see that these are the fonts, those are required. So all we have to do, we have to copy these fonts, get back to your own project, and here inside this fonts folder into your project, just click in and place all those files inside this fonts folder. Now the remaining thing is, all you need to do, you need to get back to index.html of your project and paste it here. Now just change this file name to, you are practically using the bootstrap.min.css. You see here, this is the bootstrap.min.css. So all you need to do, just copy this name. So you have connected your fontawesome.min.css to your index.html, and you have placed all those files, those are required, like this CSS files and this fonts file over here. You have placed all those things into the desired places. I am going to place now Font Awesome. That is why I am getting back here and I am clicking into these icons. I'll be requiring some icons here. For say I am using this icon envelope. So this is the class that needed to be copied. All we are going to do, we are going to copy it, and we are going to place it inside this banner too. You need to specify this. Just press Ctrl S, get back to your project and reload, and now you can see that a fa envelope has been produced over here, which is also rotating in nature, but there is a lots of things those needed to be modified. But first of all, let's complete our installation. This is the first thing that we have used. In the second place, for say, press Ctrl S, get back to your project and reload, and now you can see that all those three icons, those are present over here, and all of them are rotating. Now we have to modify, we have to customize all these three icons. We are getting back to custom.css. The first thing, the very first thing that we are going to do, we are practically turning off every kind of heights, those were provided previously. This is the first case. As you may see here, that it starts with the fa class. So all we need to do any FA class that comes under banner 2, it will be having these following properties as if color. Now if we just press Ctrl S and get back to our project and reload, now we can see that we have successfully changed this color. Now another thing we are placing here. Now we are ready to go. Press Ctrl S, get back to your project and reload, and now you can see that this thing is practically working. It is directly into this banner 2. Now another thing, provide a particular padding, reload, and you can see now this is practically working perfectly. If you want to make it a little, then just go ahead, make it 7 em, this font size, it should be considered 7 em. Press Ctrl S, get back to your project and reload, and now you can see that it is working perfectly well. Now in the same manner, what we are going to do, we are going to make changes into these two icons too. So all we are going to do now, we are going to copy this any FA class that is present within banner 3, those will be reflecting these changes. And again inside this banner 4, we are changing this class name into banner 4 FA class. Now we are ready to go. Let's press Ctrl S, get back to our project and reload, and now we can see that everything is back into its order. All we need to do, we need to make those subsequent changes inside these respective classes that is practically holding it. Now you can see that all these three icons, those are practically working perfectly well. Now the problem is those backgrounds, those needed to be taken care of. So that is why we are practically making these things off. We are commenting it out. You may comment it out or you may delete it. Now we have practically stripped it off. Change the background color off. Which background color should we change here? Banner 1 is the containing that is present behind all these things. So we need to change the background color of banner 1. That is why we are getting back to it, and here now here you can do two things. The first thing is you are placing this background color into the main containing folder, that is this banner 1, or if you just put this background, the background color of this banner 2, banner 3 and banner 4, those are being executed and banner 1 is being off. Now there are some certain changes, those could be made. Border top, provide this color code. Press Ctrl S, get back to your project, reload, and now you can see that there's a border top, but it is too much loud here. Instead of this color code, this hexadecimal color code you are placing, so this should be the color code that will be used. The color code is a little bit of faded now. If you want to make a little bit of more faded, change these values. Now everything is right in order, right on track. If you want to make some more changes, and now you can see that you are generating a text shadow. Now let's take care of these animation parts.